Greetings, folks. This is the BlackWeasel, and today is One Piece chapter 858. So we're gonna get ahead right to it. This is we have a weekly jump cover issue of Luffy sticking his fists out, Sanji doing Diablo, Jambe, and we have Big Mom, the Emperor. One of four emperors. Now, the name of the chapter is called Meeting. And, we have a wallpaper, cover of the monkeys up against the bisons. So on the monkey side, we have Zoro, Sanji, and Nami up against, Frankie, Chopper, and I think Robin. I can't see it. And Luffy is a monkey as well. While Brooke is subbing with somebody. And the name of the character is called You Lost Because You Didn't Win. Alright. Anyways, the scene starts out. The scene starts out as at the Whole Cake Tattoo, 8th floor, giant kitchen. Somebody is saying easy going. And fluffy, there's a bunch of singing going on. Life don't exist anywhere in this world. And we have a character, and the scene, it starts out as the wedding cake creation, the finale. We have a character introduction of the Big Mom Pirate, the head cooking chef, gourmet knight, Stressin. I think that's how they say his name, Stressin. And the guy is singing, a hard knock life. The taste of tears is a little salt and a little tears of regret. One tablespoon. So then for your cake, why don't just we go with a sweet one? Cooking, and then all the people yelling out, cooking chief. And all the people singing out, and easy going, fluffy. Now the scene changes towards Whole Cake Island, East Bay. And somebody's yelling out, stop it, Becoms. You gotta stay still for a little while. And lo and behold, we haven't seen Pecom since chapter 834. And yet again, he's in band-aids, just like what happened on Zoo. Well, he's always injured quite easily. And by the same guy, by Capone. Can you believe that? And Capone, and Pecom's saying, ha, ha, gaw. Did Jimmy manage to report your mama about that beggar brat? And then Aladdin says, of course, that bastard is probably getting a thorough thrashing from mama right about now. And Pecom says, Gao probably isn't gonna cut it. And Pecom says, I got no choice to make sure of this myself. And then somebody's saying, now, sha. I think the wife of Aladdin says, you gotta stay put, Pecom. And then Pecom says, but Praline, what if some chance his attempt to report gets stopped, and in the event something like this that happens, you even less able to help Jimmy. Let him do his thing. You're just gonna get hurt again. With what condition you're in, stay put. That's what Praline says. And somebody else says, that's right, Pecom. A ship doctor, I forbid you from moving. And the ship doctor says, you better stay lying down right there. Also, I think my I'm making green tea right now. So I'm gonna check on that. So I'm gonna take a mini break. Alright. And now I'm back. Okay, now I'm back. So, judging from the panels, I guess this is the end of it. Now, there's a flashback of Jimmy telling Luffy and Sanji. He says, Luffy, Sanji, Big Ed's hideout is in the northwest part of the island. And then, yeah, so that flashback ends, and Luffy and Sanji are looking at something. And Jimmy says, Well, head there ahead of you, all using the mirrors. Let's meet up there. And then Luffy yells out, wait here, this is Big Ed's hideout. I think that's what Sanji says. And then Luffy says, wait, what kind of guy is Big Ed? And then Sanji says, just think of him as a mafia boss. And then we have the introduction says, this is the fire tanks. The fire tank pirates head out. This is, we have 4 hours and 15 minutes until the tea party begins. So, the tea party is coming up. And given how the author is saying that, I guess that's something very, very major big is going to go down, obviously. But we're not sure who are the other characters involved. Anyways, Vito shows up towards the entrance. He says, whoa, my hero, Nagurma, Vince Sanji. And Sanji says, you, huh? And then Luffy says, oi, where's everyone else? Are you Big Ed? And then Vito says, I'm glad we can meet again. That's how he laughs. And we have a character introduction of Monster Gun Vito. And Vito says, don't get your bridges in a twist, boy. The others are here, Nero. And Luffy says, I can't tell what that railroad is supposed to mean, damn it. And then Chopper yells out, wow, Luffy, Sanji. And Sanji yells out, Chopper. And Chopper says, you guys should take a bath too. And Luffy says, this ain't the time to be lounging about. Where did Harry here? I thought you hated baths. And it turns out that Chopper took off his hat, so it's kind of funny to see him without his hat. And Vito says, nope, you guys gotta go. And then Vito says, father will not meet with you if you are dirty. Well, he is like a gentleman mafia boss, so like you have to have some type of decency in order to meet with mafia people. That's how they work. So there's a like a gentleman class they got going on. Anyways, you're seeing changes, and we're going inside Big Ed's hideout, the ladies' bath, and somebody else like, what? And somebody asked, Lola became a warthog zombie, and then it turns out Nami says that, so that's why she was chasing a man with her dreams. And then it turns out the other girl says, ah ha ha, that's just like Lola. And then Nami says, back then, just earlier in the haunted forest, if I hadn't run into Lola, I have no idea what even happened to me. And her sister says, I guess that's true, but you all saved my little sister too, thank you. I'm so happy I'm crying. The two of us have always been like two halves of the same person. We're twins too. Oh! So, they're twins after all. But it turns out she's the oldest, so. And then Kara said, I can't believe a dead person was able to move around. The ocean really is a wonderland. And it looks like Lola managed to become a human again, huh? And Nami says, yes. So, it turns out that Nami is explaining to everything towards Karen and the other girl about how Luffy took down Moria, I think. Anyways, her sister asks, she's probably having a blast as a pirate these days, right? And she also asks, did she manage to find a husband? And then another person says, well, Big Mom's anger is a bit terrified, and there's a small matter of running away from a wedding. And then the other girl says, yeah, that was a pretty big incident. And then, her sister says, there's a reason why all the giants in the world hate Mama. And she says that as she tending towards her son, Pets, the son of Capone Big Ed. And Nami says, huh, the giants? And she also said, I mean, despite that Thailand is supposed to be a place where all races can live, there isn't a single giant here. Yeah, Vince Mojaji pointed that out. And Kara says, and Kara's thinking to himself, giants, so they really exist. Anyways, Anyways, one of the girls says, one day, a certain person saw Lola and fell in love at first sight and decided to seek her hand in marriage. And the girl says, and that was, of all people, Loki, the prince of the giant kingdom, Elbaf. And I said, prince? Wow. And of course, Loki is named after the Vikings god Loki. And the name Loki, it comes off as a guy, a Viking guy who was known for being a miscreant and tricky person, you know? Oh shit, now I remember her name. Her name was Chiffin. Chiffin says Mama was almost crying with joy. If Lola became the princess of Elbaf, the long affection and feud with the giant would be a thing of the past. And we get access to the strongest country in the world and its famed army. Oh! So, it turns out Elbaf is also the strongest country in the world and it has a very strong army. And Nami says, I see, and she ended up running away from that wedding, huh? And then Chiffin says, it gets worse. They tried to marry me off in Lola's place, but it was found out I wasn't Lola, and well, our relationship with the giant got even worse. And Chiffin says, after all that, Big Mom essentially gave up on making any real giants her ally, instead starting to invest in methods of artificially enlarging regular people. And then Chiffin says, her anger at Lola has only increased since. At this point, she's considered a criminal in this land. If she came back, she'd be killed. And Chiffin says, also, because I just look like Lola, she doesn't like me very much. Wow, that's messed up. And then there's a flashback of Big Mom angrily yelling out, how dare you show that face before me? And then Chiffin says, every time we met, I was beaten black and blue for years. My wounds didn't even heal. Chiffin says, I thought I was going to be killed by my own parent. Oh. And Chiffin says, I don't think of that monster as my mother anymore. And then Chiffin says, Lola's a happy-go-lucky type, so I doubt she even thinks her own mom is out to kill her, but foo foo foo. And then Nami's listening, and she says, I see, now it all makes sense. And then Chiffin says, well, Beggy said that he was planning on killing Mama. I didn't feel a thing. He may think of me as a horrible, heartless creature, but that's the truth. And Nami could relate because she doesn't have any real parents. Like, her name is Nami, but so far we don't know where Nami comes from. Anyways, the scene changes towards the men's bath, and Brooks says, my, what a wonderful bath. Yo-ho-ho, paradise, just paradise. Almost can't leave. And Luffy said, why are you acting? You just like made through some fierce battle. Tighten it up a little, Brooke. We still got the real stuff to go. Oh, I can't believe it. Luffy's getting all serious. Like, he's really, really maturing. And Brooke says, oh, refrigerator. There's milk in here. Milk. And we have a big Capone pirate's underling. He says, oh, wait, don't rush through another person's refrigerator without permission, damn it. And Luffy says, oh, perfect, I lost a tooth somewhere along the way. And Brooke says, I got my face cracked. And Brooke and Luffy are drinking some milk, and they all yell out, ooh, all better. So now Luffy has his tooth back, and Brooke, his face is all repaired. That's pretty cute. And then Big A's underling yells out, the hell is up with your bodies? Anyways, the scene changes towards in a different room, and the caption says 3 hours and 30 minutes left until the tea party begins. And somebody's yelling out, I won't forgive you for this, Chiffin, you bloody kid. I can't believe you joined hands with someone trying to kill Mama. And Diesel said, Lady Chiffin, please, within your course of action, trying to assassinate Big Bomb is all but impossible. And then Chiffin said, Boulet, you know exactly what a Big Mom did to me, don't you? Lola's life is in danger, too. Big A and Piz are my family now. They're all I need. And somebody's, and turns out the door is being opened, and somebody's saying, all right, looks like everyone's here. I trust you managed to clean yourselves up a bit. Up a little, huh, eh? Clothes make demand, you say? I have no interest in talking to fools who can't even present themselves properly.
Dang! He's a serious guy. I can't believe that.
And it looks like the gang's all here, and Capone Beggy is here. Now, Capone Beggy says, now then, we got 3 hours and 30 minutes. Let's get down to it. First things first. Do we join hands or not? And Luffy's looking at him, and we have a double page of everybody looking so also fly. They're all dressed in serious clothes. And Capone Beggy says, as far as me and mine are concerned, you lot are a big pain in the ass. Often you all here would save me some sweat off my back, but. And then, Sanji cuts him off. He says, if I die, your chances of assassinating Big Mom drop to zero. The whole ceremony still will be called out after all. And if I don't make it back at least 2 hours before the party starts, people are going to start getting suspicious. And Capone says, yeah, as much as I hate to admit it, you're right. I definitely can't kill you. And Jimmy says, we don't have time to glory or small at each other. Luffy, what does your instinct tell you? Feel like joining up with these guys? And Luffy still hasn't said anything. We have Luffy in the back, Capone in the front, look at them. We have all of his guards keeping watch. Nami to the right, we have Brook, Carrot, Jimbe, Gotti the killer, Vito is his right hand man. Capone, Gotti is his left hand. Caesar Clown is joining up with Big. Caesar Clown is apparently joined hands. Pedro, Sanji, and Chopper. I can't believe it. This is such a badass moment. And Luffy is still looking. He's looking at Caesar. He's looking at him, and Luffy yells out, You're Caesar, aren't you? And Caesar's yelling like, yeah! And Chopper says, what? What? Caesar, where? And then Sanji says, he's right there, for crying out loud. And Nami is asking him, how did you realize him just now? And we have a flashback. We have a flashback of Caesar Clown. Apparently he was working on something, and he gets yelled at by somebody. He says, somebody yells out, Caesar Clown. And Caesar says, I'm working, I promise. Just tell Big Mom that, please. And Capone Beggy said, they handed me this when I took over the task of keeping an eye on you. I'm a trustworthy work now. I'll let you loose, but only if you lend me your power. It turns out Capone Beggy has the heart right now. And Capone and Caesar Clown says, you imbecile, you know who you speak and still you chose to adopt such a tone? If I so wish, I could end the very world itself. I am the genius science Caesar Clown. And the scene changes, and Caesar Clown says, Straw Hat's coming here. And Caesar says, give me a bloody break, please. That line is the last group of people I ever want to see again. And the scene flashback ends, and Caesar says, Caesar? No, I am Beggy's brother, Gangster Gastino.
Sure.
Looks like he switched sides. Now he's become Gastino. And somebody else, he's even laughing the same way. And Sanji and Chopper look somewhat scared. They're all thinking to himself, he isn't even trying to hide. What the hell is Gastino? I like his haircut. Anyways, the scene changes. And then Luffy says, must have gotten confused with someone else. My bad. And Luffy says, no, you're actually right, Florence. That's Caesar. Come on. Anyways, Luffy and Caesar are arguing. So it was really you, huh? What the heck are you doing here? And Caesar says, you think you don't want to be here? You're an adult. And Caesar says, because of you idiots, I got to hand over to Big Mom. I was about to say goodbye to this world, but then this guy got a hold of my heart and is now using it to order me around. And that goddamn travelogger, tell Law that I ever seen him again. I'll end him right then and there. And you too if I get the chance. And then Capone says, enough of that. We don't have time for this. Straw Hat, shall we join hands or no? And Capone begins to squeeze his heart. And then Luffy says, fine, but first, let me punch you once. Let me punch you once for shooting Pecans. What? Ugh. And then, Luffy's grabbing a hold of somebody. And then Jimmy says, wait, Luffy, what's the whole point of that? And Luffy says, well, you shot my friend. And then Gotti gets pissed off. He says, I won't let people talk to that way to your father. And then Vito's yelling out, stop that, Gotti. And then Capone Baker said, I don't care, go ahead. And Caesar Clown is yelling out, that's right, keep these boys out of here. And then Jimmy is holding his head like he gets tired of this. And then Jimmy says, do you like Big Bomb? And Caesar, Luffy, and Capone Baker yell out, oh, no, I hate hair. And then Jimmy says, and that's what we call an allied army. You can all kill each other later. But if we join hands here and now, each of you has something to gain out of it. And then, Luffy says, yells out, so what's our plan gonna be? And Capone Baker said, I already got a perfect one all thought up. And Caesar Clown says, just hurry and get this over with so I can finally be rid of you, cursed idiots. And that's the end of chapter 858. This is also funny.